Forget the Toys R Us big toy book.
No.
What?
I never got that.
I mean, it was like kind of like teasing yourself, but like because you just look through and you're just like, I can't obviously get all of this, but I want all of it. But
so, what was your best gift when you were little? Like the best thing you ever got?
I'm probably gonna confuse this with one of my birthday gifts. I don't know, because, like, for Christmas, like, we usually just, like, get, like, little stuff, like, clothes. Like, for, it's usually for the birthdays that my family gets, like, the great presents. I guess my Kindle. I got my Kindle last Christmas. That sounds
super lame.
When I was little, okay, here's the thing, though. When I was little, like, I would always tell my mom what I wanted for Christmas, but she never got it for me. Like, I can count literally on my fingers, like, three Christmases straight where I would ask for Pokemon Yellow, and I just never got Pokemon Yellow. Like, I'd see in the story, but I came out, and there's Pokemon Yellow. Mom, I want Pokemon Yellow for Christmas. Mom, can I... Pokemon Yellow. Birthday. Christmas. Pokemon Yellow. Like, baptism. Like, Pokemon Yellow. Like, please give me Pokemon Yellow. And oh my God. Never got it for me. I had dreams, like, every night before... Like, for those 3 years, Christmas Eve when I go to sleep, I'd have a dream that I got Pokemon Yellow. I'd wake up in the morning and didn't get Pokemon Yellow.
You're gonna judge me for this one. I was in pre-K, and I had Santa come, right? And obviously, he was fake, but he looked like... the real one, if there was one.
I used to get creeped out by those. I never want to sit on Santa's lap, ever.
I was really shy and reserved, so I was like, why am I sitting on someone else's lap? And he gave the same book away to everyone, and it's about a big black lab, whatever. And he was like, what do you want for Christmas? And I was like, I want a princess dress. No, I said, I want a Cinderella dress. He was like, okay, you'll get it. And so my mom bought me a life-size Barbie that was white and blonde, and came with
I had one of those. She wasn't, like, tall, but she was, like...
She was, like, 3 feet.
Yeah.
And she came with a dress on that fits one size, and you could fit into it, so I put it on, and it fit, and it was a blue Cinderella dress, and I was so happy. It was probably the best thing I ever got when I was little.
You know what I liked? You know what? I think the reason that I never had, like, a Christmas, like, where I was completely surprised by and, like, happy with what I got.
Because you were a cheater.
I was a cheater. I, like, the thing is, like, my parents were both working. So, like, when I was, like, really little or, like, for most of my childhood, my grandma was in the house. And my grandma pretty much stayed downstairs and watched, like, French TV shows because she thought she was French. And so... So I would just, like, be able to, like, go around the house and do whatever I wanted. So, like, when Christmas time would come around, like, my parents, like, had this, like, we had pretty much, like, our house was, like, a piece of crap when we bought it, but we fixed it up really nice. So, like, when my parents had a bathroom in their room that worked, but their shower didn't. So, like, they would always hide the gifts in the shower. And so I'd know every time. So, like, when my grandma'd be downstairs, I'd be like, and I'd look for my presents.
Wait, like, so, when like, already?
Yeah, like most of the time they were. So like when I find them, I'd like pull the tape back a little bit and be like, oh, did they get what they wanted? So I ruined it for myself for Christmas. And one time my mom was even like, I know you found them. She was like, I know you looked at them. She's like, stop doing it.
Oh my God. Yeah, I did that in fifth grade. I opened up my first Beyonce True Star perfume and a Sierra CD.
A Sierra CD.
I like Sierra. Sierra. I love her. And it was a CD. Like, who the heck asked for a CD? You know, those things aren't even in style anymore. It's crazy. I think we should cut to a song break. I'm feeling awkward.
All right. So now we're going to play a song on computer with a program, which is so much more hip than a CD. We are going to play... This playlist is kind of lacking.
Lacking. Play Elvis Blue Christmas. I love that song.
All right, number one, you're going to make me play Christmas music. That's strike number one. You're going to make me play Elvis.
Do-do-do-do-do. Without you, I'll be so blue.
Oh, my God. I want to play that Ying Yang Twins song, but I really can't.
I know.
I want to play it.
I'm interested to hear what they have to say.
Yeah. Alright, we're gonna try and look for a clean version of Deck de Club by Ying Yang Twins. Because
in the meantime, we should play something.
I know, I'm
well known.
Well known. Alright, there's no more well known than this.
Hang all the mistletoe, I'm gonna get to know you better. This Christmas, and as we trim in the tree. How much fun it's gonna be together this Christmas. The fireside is blazing bright.